हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ई कीड़ा। टाइटल ऑफ द लेक्चर इज सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ टावर फुटिंग रेजिस्टेंस इन रिलेशन टू लाइटनिंग। सी, टावर फुटिंग रेजिस्टेंस इज द रेजिस्टेंस, टावर फुटिंग रेजिस्टेंस इज द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफर्ड बाय द मेटल पार्ट by the metal parts of the tower plus the ground resistance. This tower footing resistance is important. Why it is important? It is important for the protection against surge voltages. Thus, the very purpose of using the earth wire on top to shield the phase conductor is lost if the tower footing resistance, is not kept low. See, we know lightning strikes tends to terminate on the earth wire or tower. So, depending on factors such as conductor, tower, soil impedance, and magnitude of the strike, it will result in flashover across the insulator. And the resultant fault surge will propagate along the line until it is extinguished or the breaker operate. This we already studied in lightning surges. So this movement of surge current of associated equipment such as circuit breakers and transformers and impacts network performance adversely. So tower footing resistance needs to be kept uniform. And as low as possible to prevent back flash over across the insulator. Under lightning conditions. So the significance of this low tower footing resistance results in less voltage stresses across the line insulation. See, we know lightning strike to the tower results in high current flowing into the ground. Through the tower footing. So this gives rise. So this gives rise to soil ionization and thermal effects. So as a result, the ground resistance of the tower base. Decreases by an amount depending on the soil resistivity. Current magnitude. And tower footing construction. Hence, the tower footing resistance should be as low as possible. To prevent line back flashover and maintain the ground potential rise. Maintain the ground potential rise within safety tolerance. Now, there are two factors that affect the tower footing resistance. First one is the electrode configuration, and second one is the soil resistivity. So, first, electrode configuration. See, electrode configuration, an earth electrode is a metal plate. Pipe or conductor electrically connected to earth. So they are usually made of copper or aluminium. There are some factors that influence the earthing. First one is resistance of the electrode. Second, composition of the soil. In the immediate neighborhood. Third, temperature of the soil. Moisture content of the soil. And depth of the electrode. Second factor is soil resistivity, which affect the tower footing resistance. B is the soil resistivity. See, soil resistivity can be defined as the resistance of a cube of soil of 1 meter size measured between any two opposite faces in ohm meters. And this is a key factor in determining the resistance of the charging electrode and the depth level it should be planned to obtain low resistance. Now, soil resistivity depends on following factor. Actually, the resistance of soil differ place to place and fluctuate seasonally. So, it depends on following factor. First factor is moisture, second mineral, third dissolved salts, so the lower the soil resistivity is, the less number of electrodes required to achieve the desired earth resistance value. And there is one more factor on which it depends. See, the layer thickness. The soil environment can be considered as an upper layer and a more conductive lower layer. Thank you.